What's good, man? It's Tech Tuesdays, man, and I'm gonna do a review on the Sony A6500. Yeah, you're probably wondering why I'm wearing this Iron Man helmet. Everybody knows that's been watching my page for like just a few weeks. It hasn't even been that long. But even in this short time period, everybody understands I love superheroes. And so, who else better to do a tech review than Iron Man, the king of tech, man? So, like, we're just gonna dive in, man. I really wanted to like this camera. On paper, it's immaculate, but it has like some small little quirks as far as usability goes that I think really needs to be addressed before you consider buying this. So like, you have to ask yourself, what do you want to do with this camera? Like, are you vlogging? Are you using it for weddings? Like, when I was looking at this with this camera, I was like, okay, cool. What did I want to use it for? What I wanted to use it for specifically was the vlogging aspect. I was like, okay, it's a small camera. I can take my monopod, my little bitty monopod. I can slide it on there, you know, and kind of like have this perfect vlogging setup. And so what I did is I have my Rode Micro on my A-Duty right now while I'm recording. But I used that and I was like, it's perfect. And then I got around to it and I started to record and I couldn't flip the screen out and look at myself. So I couldn't frame myself well. I didn't know if I was exposed properly. And a lot of times I wasn't. So I have to look at it, then go back, change the exposure, then start recording over again, just to kind of make sure, you know what I'm saying, that I was in focus, that it wasn't picking up on anybody else. And like a lot of times when I vlog, I have my family with me, I have my wife with me, I have my little girl in the background. And sometimes I want to be on focus, but it'll pick up somebody in the background in focus. And it was just kind of really messy sometimes. And I get the footage and think that it was great, and I wasn't in focus, and it was just like a really bummer. And it'd be great if the screen was turned around so I can like click myself just so I can make sure that I was in focus, which the ADD has, and that's what I'm shooting on right now. And then with the face detection, I'm sorry about that, but there's a lot of little quirks that I had with this. And so like, I really, really tried, like, I love Canon, so like, I'm not, look, because everybody just, well, I kind of am a Canon fanboy, I guess, if that's what you call it. But I have a 1DX Mark II, I have an 80D, and I have a 5D Mark III, and I just love Canon colors, and I love the usability of this thing. Like, I can turn around, click on somebody's face, and go with it, but it's not perfect for vlogging, because it doesn't have the articulated screen either. And so I really wanted to have 4K in my vlogs, and I really wanted to have the option of doing slow motion on my vlogs, but I couldn't do that. But with, you know, not with the 80D, because it doesn't have 4K. It has the articulating screen, which is great, and it has a great image quality, but it didn't have 4K, and it didn't have slow motion, which was like a bummer for me. So I was like, when they came out with this, I was like, okay, I'm getting it. And I got it, and it just has too many hiccups. First of all, was the menu setting. Like, so you dive into the menus, let me cut it on really quick and show you guys. Like, so you dive into the menu, and it has this like really, really, really complicated menu setting. And a lot of people have talked about it before, but I just kind of ignored it. I was like, okay, they just didn't take the time, because I found like little workarounds. I was like, you can press the function button, the FN button, and then you can get to a lot of those things that you need really, really quickly. But what I didn't know before I purchased it was, okay, the battery life. I knew the battery life was bad, so when I record something really good, I cut it off really quick. And then, because I didn't want to waste the battery. And then I would cut it back on really fast, and I would lose my picture profile. Not in the movie mode, but the 1 and 2 settings. Like, if you cut it off and cut it back on, then it goes to picture profile off. And so, like, if I had it in picture profile 1 and I had it set up perfectly, I would lose that. And a lot of times I would think that it was on, or I forget it, and then it wasn't what I thought. And so that was really aggravating. And like I said, another thing was the battery life. I could go to a ball game, and within so many minutes, it would go dead, like 30 minutes into it. But I did find a workaround for that. I got me like an external battery. I thought I had it with me, but I don't. But I had an external battery and that helped. But it just added to what I had to have. So then I said, okay, I'll give me a small monitor. Then I put me a monitor on there. And then, of course, you had to have a mic on there. So then it started to grow in size at that point. And so, like, it lost that appeal of being a small setup, a pick-up and go type deal, because you had to do so many things to get it working. And then, like, but I will say this, with the 6300, they had a lot of overheating issues. I've never had an overheating issue with this. So that is one plus about this. And like I said, it has great image quality. It's just, it's in post, I have to do too much to get it to where I want it, if that makes sense. Because Canon, like, I can shoot with my 80D or my 1DX Mark II and pull it straight into there and edit and go with it as far as vlogging go. But like with this one, like, I had to do a lot of color grading. Well, not a lot of color grading, but I had to color grade it, which added to time. And with vlogs, like, you want to get them out quick, and because you might be doing more than one, two, or three, or four a week. And so, like, that really killed it for me. But like I said, it depends on what you're trying to do with it. This can be a great camera, but for me personally, for vlogging, it just didn't do it for me. And for the people out there that was like, okay, he's just a Canon guy, he wasn't really trying, he just picked it up just to say he didn't like it, I really, really wanted to like this thing. Like, it has so many great features. And I feel like if you change a few things in this thing, like the menu, if you go in the menu and you simplify it, or you change it, or even if you go like where you can go within an app or something, or hook it up to your computer and change some things. I like the function button. I love that. Keep that. But as far as the way you move around, maybe like a small thumbstick or something, maybe, to make it easier to get through the settings, maybe, I guess, might help. But it's just like, it's all over the place. And it's just too much. Like, you got gamma, you got picture profile, and what else? Because it's a bunch of them. Let me go through. But like I said, man, I really, really tried to like this camera. And like, not to say, man, like, if you did make a few changes, I'll come back and I'll try it again. I'm not one of those people like that's just afraid to go away from Canon. But like I said, like, just to let you know, like, that I tried. I went out and I bought me a nifty 50 in the Sony world. But like I said, like, with the sensor being so small, the depth of field is not the same that you would normally get. If I put a Nifty 50 on my 80 or my 1DX Mark II, then like, the depth of field is still crazy. But see, like, it was just like, I didn't get that same depth of field with this 1.8. And yes, for low light, it was a whole lot better. It saved me in a couple areas. And then I'm gonna talk about that low light on this camera as well. And then, and so, like, I got a lot of Canon lenses. I got an 85mm 1.2. 24mm 1.4 in Sigma, the Arts, and then I got the 18-35mm. And so, because I had those lenses, I went out and I bought this adapter. And like, man, this is a great adapter. Like, it's not as expensive as the Metabones, but it's really, really good. It works really well, but you lose some features as far as autofocus go when you use this adapter. And so that was hurtful. And then as well, like, when you went to 125 frames per second, you lose like face detection. So a lot of times, like, and that tap to focus was a little bit off sometimes, especially when I used this. And so you lost that. So like, I would have like a beautiful moment in slow motion, and it's in focus. It's close to being in focus, but it's not all the way in focus, and you can tell. It's not very, it's not sharp in the places that I needed it to be sharp. And so it'll miss every once in a while. And that was a big drawback for me too as well. And then I tried this as well. Also, this, I love the focal length on this. The 18-105, this is a G Master. And I love the way they did the power zoom. And like, if you got a remote, I actually bought the little small remote too that also go with it, and it works great, especially for like, if you're trying to do like a parallax. So like, if you got this thing on a gimbal and you're moving forward and then you zoom, and then it makes it, and it's so smooth, and it's nice. And I love that about that. That was like, it, that alone almost made me want to keep it. That alone. And I might still keep it. I'm still playing around with it. I'm still trying to figure it out, because I really, really want to like this camera. as far as vlogging goes. But what killed it for me is the L4. I mean, it just, and everybody says, okay, well, you can step down. But like, honestly, like at receptions, when it's kind of dark in receptions and stuff, and you want to get that shot, it was still grainy, and I couldn't really push the ISO far enough to really get it the way I wanted it. And that's where this lens really lacks, and they really don't have a lot of fast lenses in the Sony lineup, and that's why I had to get the adapter to get that 85 1.2. But then it turns into like way for like a 10, it's one something after you do the multiplication or whatever. I'm not really exactly sure what that is, but like I said, great camera, but for what I needed for it just didn't do what I needed it to do. But I'm open for any suggestions. Like, if you're watching this video, I wanted to help the people out there want to use this for vlogging, or they just want to know a little bit about it. I know it wasn't really, really tech. I didn't really go over a lot of specs, but sometimes that's not what you need. Sometimes you need to just know what this camera can do and what it can't do, and what it's good for and what it's not good for. And so I hope this tech review, I hope it kind of helped a little bit. And if you have any suggestions, or if you have any tips, then let me know. And I was about to buy, I think they have like a really, really fast 85 millimeter now, but I didn't want to like dive too far into it. But I did dive in a little bit. I kind of stuck my foot in, but I didn't dive in all the way until I knew that this was a camera that I actually really wanted to go with. Like, if it was something outside of vlogging that I would use for a wedding or something like that, then I would just dive off and buy those lenses. But it's just not there for me, especially with the battery life as far as weddings and stuff go and stuff like that, because we do weddings and small events and stuff like that. But for those, man, for those events, I'm carrying my baby. This thing is amazing. I'm gonna probably do a tech review on this too as well. And y'all let me know what superhero next y'all want me to do, man. I got them all, man. I got Black Panther, I got Power Rangers, I got, you know what? The next tech review, I'm gonna probably do Batman, because that's my other tech guy as far as that go. But man, like I said, man, I love superheroes, man. Tech Tuesdays, man. I'm out. Like, share, and subscribe, man. If you have any suggestions, put them inside the comments below. Let me know any questions, any other tech reviews that you need. Like I said, put them down there. Let me know, and we'll go from there, man. Peace out. Wait. Look, I did all of that, and I didn't even show you this. Watch this. It's so cool. Watch this.
I am Iron Man. That was a terrible. That was terrible. Like, I didn't do that well at all.
Yeah, I tried to change my voice, but it didn't work. But wasn't that dope, though? Like, my toys are awesome. It's so fun being a kid. Peace out.